गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू गाइस, गुड इवनिंग, सत श्री अकाल, नमस्ते, सलाम वालेकुम। इफ यू आर जस्ट जॉइनिंग इन, टाइप इन योर नेम, टाइप इन विच सिटी यू आर कनेक्टिंग फ्रॉम। इफ यू आर जस्ट जॉइनिंग इन, टाइप इन योर नेम, टाइप इन विच सिटी यू आर कनेक्टिंग फ्रॉम। गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू गाइस। टाइप इन योर नेम, टाइप इन विच सिटी यू आर कनेक्टिंग फ्रॉम, सो दैट आई गेट टू नो विच पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड you are based out of. So type in your name, type in which city, which country you are connecting from. Good evening to all of you, welcome to all of you. I'm going to give maybe 30 more seconds, maybe one more minute, 60 more seconds for people to join in. People have enough time to be able to join in, to be able to log in, and then I'm going to start today. So if you're there on this live session, please type in your name. Please type in your name, type in which city, which part of the world you're connecting from. I want to make it interactive, so it depends upon you as well to make it interactive. So please let me know who you are and where are you based out of. Just type in your name, type in which city you're connecting from, so that I get to know who all have been following this live session. I can see a few people, but there is no response in terms of your name. So please type in your name. I would really appreciate if you can type in your name. Type in where you are connecting from, please go ahead and we're gonna start in next 50 seconds, 60 seconds, maybe a minute more for people to be able to have enough time to be able to log in. So welcome Pradnya Pal from Nagpur, fantastic. Please go ahead and type in your name, type in the city, type in where you are connecting from, please go ahead. So today's topic is very, very interesting. I'm very excited about today's topic. And the reason I'm very excited about today's topic, how to create your own personal economy, is the reason being because I think in times like today, especially in times like today, when there are so uncertain times, and the reason I say uncertain times, because I don't have to say it, all people are aware of it, the kind of economical situation which is going on, not only in India, around the world, because the world is interconnected, right? So I'm very excited about today's topic, and I'm going to start maybe in a couple of minutes. So welcome Wadilal from Jaipur, welcome Siddharth, welcome Sunil from Santa Cruz, from Mumbai, I think. So welcome guys, welcome all of you. Welcome all of you. If you're there on this live session, please type in your name. Type in your name, type in where you're connecting from. Welcome Rohini. Welcome Rohini. Type in your name, type in your the city where you're connecting from. So like I said, I'm very excited about today's session for the simple fact that talking about creating personal economy, first of all, it was a huge thing that I want to take it up, because I really want to help people to be able to know what it takes for them to create their own personal economy. First of all, a lot of people will have questions in their mind as to how can you go about creating your own personal economy? Is there something like creating personal economy even exist? And the answer is yes. So today I'm going to speak about certain practical steps, like always. If you have been following me through any medium, through my live sessions, through my webinars or anything, you would know that I would always make sure that you have practical step-by-step methods. So today I'm going to give you four practical methods for you to create your own personal economy. So I'm going to take some more time before people are there, so that I'm your biggest fan. So Alok, thank you so much for that. Thank you Alok from Bangalore. Fantastic. So I have people joining in now. This is fantastic. So thank you first of all for giving your time. And today is Saturday evening. Anyways, most people are at home. So you have all the reasons to give yourself a time to be able to learn something new, and especially about your economy, about your financial growth. So I am glad that all of you are here. Welcome Krishna Vani from Chennai. So welcome all of you guys. So I think I'm going to start. There will be people who will be joining in. So like I said, today's topic is first of all very interesting. I'm very excited, and the reason I'm excited is because, see, first of all, let's understand that all of us are going through uncertain times. Okay, not only as a country but across the world. But in times like this, it is always a perspective as to how do you want to go about creating your own personal economy. Now a lot of people will say, Ravneet, is it really possible to create our own personal economy? Because the entire world economy is interconnected. We all are interconnected. So if economies are going for a toss, if countries' economies are going for a toss, it means that everybody in that country, everybody in that economy, everybody in the world economy, whether you're into a job, whether you're into a business or any kind of profession, you are going to be affected. So I'm not denying that. You will be affected in one way or the other. But there are certain methods that I'm going to speak to you today. There are certain things that I'm going to talk to you with. If you follow these methods, okay, if you follow some of these strategies that I'm going to tell you today, no matter what kind of an economy is going on, no matter what kind of a world situation going on in terms of money, in terms of finances, it is going to allow you to be able to take charge of your own personal economy. So before I go ahead with that, first of all, your mindset needs to be right. You got to get a perspective, right? You have to have an open mind that, you know what, if I'm there on this call today, if I'm there on this live session, I'm going to have an open mind to be able to listen to what I have to say and how I can implement, because the only thing which is going to help you is implementation, execution. A lot of gyan, a lot of learning, a lot of information is going to be passed on from various platforms from across the world. Today I have some information to give it to you, but I'm not going to just give you information. My intent is to how you take this information and implement. So I'm going to tell you how you can implement this as well. But for that to happen, you got to have an open mind. So if you are ready to have an open mind with me, and if you are ready with your notepads and pens, because if you think that you're going to remember everything, whatever that I'm going to say by the end of the session, and you don't make any notes, it is not going to happen. So I would encourage you to make sure that you have something to write upon, something to be able to go back and reflect upon. If you have a notepad and pen, great. If you do not have, I would encourage you to not just watch this live session. I would encourage you to keep something with you so that you can make notes. And not just bullet points. Not just bullet points. If I'm telling you how to be able to go ahead and implement, make notes. Keep writing, because like I say, all the point in this world of taking knowledge, information is execution, implementation. And that's where your mental toughness needs to come into the picture. So if you're ready with me on this, and if you have a notepad and a pen ready, mention I am ready. Mention I am ready. Welcome Sneha. Welcome Sneha. Welcome Shashi. Mention where you're connecting from, guys, as well. Mention your city name as well. And if you're ready with notepads and pens, if you have something to write upon, mention I am ready. Then I'm going to go ahead. Mention I am ready. Mention I am ready in the chat box. Mention I am ready in the chat box. I would like to hear all of your point of view. Mention I am ready in the chat box. Mention I am ready in the chat box. Mention I am ready in the chat box. Fantastic. Krishna Veri, fantastic. Fantastic, Avinash. So, let's start. So, I'm going to talk about today four powerful methods. Four powerful methods which is going to allow you to create your own personal economy. There's a difference. I'm not talking about what is going on at the macro level. What is going on in your country? See, government of any country will gonna come up with their own packages to be able to support various sections of the economy, various sections of the country. They are going to come up with their own packages. But the point is, if you are going to be dependent on the government, then you are not going to become a person who's going to take charge of your money, your financial growth. Is it important to be able to take charge of your own financial growth no matter what you do? Absolutely. Why? Because today the world is run through money. The world is run through paper currency. There was a time when the world used to run through barter system. But today, since last hundreds, maybe 500 years ago, thousands years, since last thousand years, the world is run through paper currency, which means if you do not learn how to be able to take charge of this paper currency, which is to create your own economy, to create your own financial growth, no matter what is going on at a macro level, it's not going to help. So there are methods, there are strategies that I have implemented in my life. I teach some of the participants who work with me, and I'm going to speak about these strategies, although this is something that I share with people who are part of my inner circle, part of my mastermind communities. But I'm going to share these strategies with you, and I want you to make sure that you have an open mind to be able to listen and implement these strategies. All of these strategies are very, very implementable, are very, very easy. And for that to happen, you got to have the right approach. So I'm going to speak about these four methods in detail, and I want you to make notes of it. Okay. So how do you create your own personal economy? Can you be indifferent to whatever is going on at the macro level in your country, in your state, in your city? Yes, you can. So let's talk about a step-by-step method. How can you create your own personal economy? There are four methods or four skills that I'm going to talk about which you can inculcate within you for you to create your own personal economy. What are these skills? The first skill which can help you to create your own personal economy no matter what is going on in the world is called acquiring high income skills. Acquiring high income skills. What do I mean by acquiring high income skills? I mean skills which allows you to have more high income. If I talk about in India, skills which you can make use of for you to be able to easily earn a lakh rupees easily per month in India. So what are those skills? These skills you bring into the market, and the market will pay you for it no matter what is going on in the economy. So I'm going to talk about what are these high income skills which anybody, whether today you are in a job, whether today you have your own business, no matter what kind of a business that is in, Whether you're an actor, whether you're an artist, no matter whosoever you are, any profession, there are certain high income skills which you can inculcate within you. So no matter what is going on in the economy, if you have these high income skills within you, it allows you to still earn a lot of money even in recession stage, even in difficult economic times. So what are these high income skills? One of the first skill, which is a high income skill, irrespective of the economy, irrespective of the global situation in today's world, is called copywriting. It's called copywriting. I don't know how many of you are aware what is copywriting, so I'm going to try my level best to be able to explain what is copywriting. Understand this in detail. Copywriting is nothing but any form of written content, any form of written text through which any products or any services around the world is being sold. Any company, any businesses, any entrepreneurs, when they have to sell their products or services out there in the market, they use copywriting. So in which all methods copywriting is being used? Copywriting is being used in any form of advertisements. Copywriting is being used in any form of sales pages. Copywriting is being used in any form of landing pages. Today, when you have come out to this Facebook Live, how come you've come out to this Facebook Live? Because there's a certain title, which is how to create your own personal economy, which attracted you, which is nothing but copy. It's a written form of content which attracts the audience, which attracts the interest of a certain section of the society which would be interested to know about this particular topic. Any product, any service today in this world is sold through copy. So today, if you work in a job, your resume is your copy. It's a written form of content which allows you to be able to best project yourself out there to a prospective employer. If today you're a sales professional, you make proposals and you write something in those proposals in the form of written content, that is called copy. Today, any product, any services are being sold through copy in various methods. So if anything is being sold through copy, which is written form of content, even video sales letters, don't you think no matter what kind of an economy will be going on, copywriting is a skill which is always going to be in high demand? Why? Because companies will always want to sell their products and services. And if companies would always want to sell their products and services, which means copywriters will always be in high demand. So let me give you an example. When I started out years back, doing what I'm doing today, coaching people, mentoring people, when I had nobody to be able to work for me, I was the one who used to write copies. If you have been part of my subscriber list, the emails that you get, even today, I write those emails because I like to write my emails on my own. That's copy. It creates interest. It gives you certain strategies. It gives you certain methods. Anything that you see in the form of sales promotion, marketing material, brochure, any of these things is copy. Today, most people are stuck in their jobs. They are doing their 9-to-5 jobs. Or let's say that you have a business. You're doing your business. First of all, most business people, they never are able to scale up their business because they lack certain high income skills. The skills to be able to take the businesses to the next level. Most entrepreneurs are not even aware how to scale up a business, how to build a team, how to create certain processes, how to create certain systems. If you are not being able to have the right identity of an entrepreneur and you don't have the right skills for you to take your business to the next level, at least create another source of income by acquiring certain high income skill. In fact, copywriting as a skill is also going to happen in your business. Why? Because in any business, either you are selling a product or you are selling a service. If you can have your own copywriting skill or you can hire people, through copywriting skills, your business can go off the roof. If you're in a job, why can't you think of having a high income skills which can allow you to work as a freelancer? Which can allow you to work as a freelancer. Now, some of you might think, Ravneet, I don't know how to write. I can't come up with sales copies. I can't come up with sales pages. I can't come up with all of this content because I'm not a writer. First of all, please understand that all of the skills that I'm going to talk about in terms of high income skills, the first method, all of these are learnable skills. And in this world, no skill that you today have, you got it when you were born out of your mother's womb. Every skill is learned, my friends. If you today know how to write a mail, how to send a mail, if you today know how to be able to speak to somebody over the phone in a certain way, articulation, that's a skill that you have learned over a period of time. All of these skills are learnable skills. The only thing which is going to stop you to not do that because you will come up with your own mental limitations. You know what? I cannot do that because I don't have time. I cannot do that because my job takes so much of my time, or I can't do that because I'm not a writer. Even I was not a writer, but I used to write from the heart. And today, I am not doing all of this stuff, copywriting, but I have people. But the point that I am saying is today, even if you are working in a job, imagine if you have got certain high income skills. And I just spoke about one income skill, high income skill, which is called copywriting. Imagine if you have got certain high income skills. Would it allow you, even if you, let's say, end up losing your job, even your company fires you, let's say your business is going for a toss. If you have a high income skills, are there companies out there? Are there businesses out there? Are there entrepreneurs out there who need copywriting skills no matter what economy is going on? Absolutely. If that skill is in high demand, would that mean whether your one income stream gets completely demolished, there is no income which is coming? If you have another income skill, which is a high income skill such as copywriting, can you as a freelancer, no matter what your age is, no matter what your background is, if you can learn this skill, can you not take charge of your own personal economy? Absolutely. Today, copywriting is such a huge skill out there in the market, and it is in such a demand because we are living in a digital world. We are living in a digital world where everything, all the eyeballs are there, where people, companies, entrepreneurs are trying to catch eyeballs of the audiences, prospective customers through copywriting. Ask yourself today, no matter what job I am doing it, even if I am a marketing guy, I am a SCM guy, I am a sales guy, I am an operation guy, if you have a business, ask yourself, apart from a business, what skills do I have? If I lose my business, if my business is not working, do I have some high income skills? If not, obviously you're always going to be in the mercy of the macroeconomy. Always you're going to be in the mercy of the government packages. Always you're going to be on the mercy on the external factors and not the internal ones. Today, copywriting is one skill which anybody can learn. And if anybody can learn that skill, the only thing that you got to do is you got to put in some form of effort and you got to put in some form of time for you to learn this skill. High income skills are such skills when I'm going to talk about that these skills always remain in demand, my friends. No matter what kind of an economy goes, because people will always have to sell products and services and people will always buy certain products and services, which means they will always need some form of copy. If you can acquire this copywriting as a skill, it allows you to take charge of your own personal economy, no matter what kind of an economy it is going on around. So that's the first high income skill. If you have any questions, I would entertain all the questions at the very end. So keep your questions with you. I'm gonna answer all the questions at the very end. The first method that I'm right now speaking about is acquiring high income skills. If you, as any kind of a professional today, acquire certain high income skills, it allows you to make money, it allows you to create another source of income even if you lose your job, even if your business is not working. And one of the skills is called high income skills. In high income skills, one of the skills that I've just spoken about is called copywriting. The second skill which anybody can learn, again it's a learnable skill, especially in today's world, it is in high demand, is a digital marketing skill. Is a digital marketing skill. What do I mean by digital marketing? Anything which creates funnels for companies, funnels for business, funnels for entrepreneurs. It allows you to be able to make money out of that. In digital marketing, there are so many things that you can learn. You can learn content marketing, you can learn email marketing, you can learn SEO, search engine optimization, which allows traffic to be driven to your website, traffic to be driven to your sales pages. Social media marketing, social media handling. Today, as a person who is working for a particular company, as a person who is working in a heavy, running a certain business, if you start acquiring any form of digital marketing skill today, any form of digital marketing skills, no matter what economy will go on, you will never come into a position to not make money, because digital marketing will always be in demand. Why? Ask yourself why digital marketing will be in demand no matter what kind of a situation that we are going in. No matter what kind of economic situation that we are going in. Today, look at this. Today, most people are under the lockdown stage. What's the first thing, which is one industry, by the way, which is one or couple of industries, or all the industries are making use of today for them to reach out to their customers? What is one platform? What is one macro platform which most of the businesses out there, no matter what business, not only just webinars or a coaching or a consulting industry, any kind of industry, what medium they are using for them to be able to reach out to prospective customers? The medium that they are using is digital medium. Why? Because think about it. For any companies, for any businesses, for any entrepreneurs, if they have to sell their products and services, where are the eyeballs in today's world? Today, most of the eyeballs are on digital medium. Digital media, mediums like social media, your internet, your Facebook, your Instagram, your TikTok, all of these mediums. If the eyeballs are there, don't you think company will make use of digital medium for them to reach out to the prospective customers, to the prospective clients? If that's the case, don't you think if you as a professional have any sort of a digital marketing skill within you, you will always be in high demand no matter what the economy is going on? Ask yourself, absolutely. Today, I have so many people who are working in my organization, my company, who are making use of digital marketing skills, and they are earning the money which they are earning from me. Why? Because no matter what kind of an economic environment is there, today, digital marketing is always going to be in demand because products need to be sold, services need to be sold, and people will always buy certain products and certain services which solve their problem. And for that to happen, you've got to acquire the skills which are relevant today. And these skills is always going to be relevant because the more we move towards, let's say today we are in 2020, in 2030, in 2025, digital marketing will be boom. In fact, today, right now, digital marketing as an industry is a multi-million dollar industry in India. And by 2025, it is going to be a billion dollar industry. Ask yourself, what's the percentage of share? What's the percentage of share that you in this billion dollar industry is having for your own self? Today, if you acquire this digital marketing skill, any skill, you don't have to become a digital marketing manager or digital marketing expert. Like I said, in digital marketing, you can learn so many things: SEO, content marketing, digital email marketing, your social media handling, your social media, being a social media manager. There are so many skills that you can learn. If you can learn even one skill in digital marketing as a macro skill, imagine, would you not have your control over your personal economic situation? Because this will always be in demand. So the second skill in high income skills, these are all high income skills. Companies, anybody will pay you high income. Like I said, at least minimum to minimum, if you do good things, if you do the right things, if you do the right things, minimum in India today, in India, as a freelancer, I'm saying, as a freelancer, you can make 1 lakh rupees minimum. Obviously, you need to put some form of effort. Obviously, you need to put some form of time. But today, imagine if you have got a high income skill, guys, apart from your job. I'm not saying don't work in your job. I'm not saying don't take your respective business to the next level. But you, if you are there on this live call, why are you there? You are there so that I can learn certain ideas which can allow me to be able to better prepare for the next economic downturn, for the next recession, for the next time when economy goes for a toss. I am not going for a toss. Today, I'm seeing so many people are creeping about their jobs, are creeping about their cash inflows, are creeping about their lack of clients in the businesses because they have not got certain high income skills which allows them to even make money in these times. So in high income skills, the first skill that I spoke about is copywriting. The second skill that I spoke about is digital marketing. If you acquire this couple of skills in any kind of an economy, you will always be in charge. Do not think, you know what, I am an SCM guy, I am an operation guy. Mujhe sirf isi ke bare mein pata hai. Agar ye approach rakhoge na life mein, to phir cheeze nahi hoti hai. You got to put yourself into a position to learn. Just because you have done operation work, you have handled supply chain management for last 30 years of your life, doesn't mean you're not going to learn something new. Why do you want to learn something new? The reason you want to learn something new so that in any kind of a situation, finances, money, financial growth, you are in control. Not the macroeconomy, not because of what is going on, because of coronavirus, because of another world war, or because of another economic downturn, because of anything. You will be in charge. Why? Because these high income skills will always be there. If you are with me on this, if you understand this, mention yes in the chat box. Mention yes in the chat box. Welcome Piyush, welcome Vijay, welcome Sahil, welcome Prateek, welcome Branu. Well, mention yes in the chat box. If you are with me, if you understand, why do you need to acquire certain high income skills? Mention yes in the comment box. Mention yes in the comment box. The first powerful method that I'm right now speaking about is acquiring high income skills. The first one is copywriting. The second one is digital marketing. And the third one, and the most favorite one, this is my favorite one, personal favorite, is high ticket closing. High ticket closing. Please understand what I'm saying. High ticket closing. What do I mean by high ticket closing? High ticket closing means, again, look at the macro perspective. In any kind of an economic situation, would companies, entrepreneurs, businesses need somebody to close leads for their business? Do they need somebody to be able to close potential clients, to be able to close prospects? Absolutely yes. If any business, any company, any entrepreneur needs somebody to close their potential leads, to close their potential prospects, if you have a skill which is a high closing skill, you are a high ticket closer. High ticket closer means you know how to close big ticket items, big ticket contracts, big amount of value agreements, big ticket products, if you have a income scale which is of high ticket closing, you can close bigger deals, you can close deals which is of higher amount. Would you as a freelancer would always be in demand if you know how to close potential leads in any industry? Let's say today, let's say you're a sales professional in IT industry. Maybe you are selling IT products and services. Today you're already a sales professional in IT industry. If you today become a sales professional which also knows, let's say, to close high ticket items. High ticket means deals with bigger value, products and services with bigger value. Can you not as a freelancer you can work, you can approach certain companies which allows you to close leads for them? They will give you leads, they will give you potential prospects. You need to close it for them, maybe through cold calling, maybe through meeting. Today I know there are so many companies who are not hiring full-time sales professionals. Listen to me carefully, this is the world where it is going on. Companies today are not hiring full-time sales professionals. They are hiring part-time high ticket closers, people who can close potential leads for them, people who can, they give a certain percentage of margin to them. This skill will always be in demand, especially if today you are already into sales, any kind of a sales, let's say medical sales, IT sales, pharma sales, any kind of sales. If you're already a sales professional, which means you already have certain sales skills, the only thing that you got to upgrade is you got to learn how to be able to handle and close high ticket sales. If you have been closing, let's say, sales of, let's say if you're into pharma industry and you're closing sales of, let's say, maybe 40,000, 50,000, a lakh rupees, can you close sales which is over and a half, 2 lakh, 3 lakh? Can you close a product and service which is of higher amount? If you acquire the skills of high ticket closing, you will always win demand. You will always be in charge of personal economy. There are sites like Upwork, like Fiverr, like TrueLancer. There are so many freelance websites where today, if you out of all the skills, digital marketing skills, copywriting skills, high ticket closing skills, if you are a person who has any of these skills, guys, today you can start making money easily, because there are companies out there who would always have a demand for these kind of professionals, copywriter, your digital marketer, your high ticket closing. And what I'm saying is all of these are learnable skills. Please understand, you got to put in some effort, you got to put in some time. And it is not something which is going to take a huge time. The only thing that is going to take certain form of dedication, certain form of time for yourself. And if you really want to take charge of your own personal economy, don't tell me that you are going to do that by conventional ways. You can't be doing conventional ways. All rich people, all financially intelligent people, all financially literate people. There's a difference between literacy and financial literacy. All financially literate people, they always acquire these high income skills within them. As a business professional, or as a person who is on the path of financial growth, for them to make sure that no matter what economy goes on, I have certain skills which allows me to make money in any kind of an economy. So right now, I just spoke of first powerful method, which is called acquiring high income skills. Acquiring high income skills allows you to be in charge of your own personal economy, no matter what is going on around you, in your country, around the world. What are those high income skills? I just spoke about 3 high income skills. There are many more. I just spoke about 3 high income skills. First one is copywriting. Anything that you see today, which is being sold in the market through any promotional material, through any marketing material, is nothing but a copy. I gave an example of today, your resume is your copy, because your resume is a portrait of what you have done or not done. So whatever the written form of content, written form of text, it is a copy. If you start today acquiring the skill to write fantastic copies, this skill will allow you to get contracts, to be able to become a freelancer to so many businesses, so many entrepreneurs, and you will be in charge of your own personal economy. Second high income skill that I spoke about, digital marketing skill. In digital marketing skill, you can go about learning SEO, you can go about learning email marketing, content marketing, social media handling, social media manager. You can do any of this micro skill in a digital marketing skill as a macro skill for you to be always in demand, because the entire world is going to move to digital medium. The businesses today who are not understanding how to leverage digital media, is nothing but internet, okay? How to leverage digital media for them to take their businesses online in any which way, they are going to suffer. Because all the eyeballs, 7.8 billion population, look at the amount of internet connectivity which is there even in rural areas today. And this is only going to increase. Imagine the world where 7.8 billion people are already on the internet. If they are on the internet, eyeballs on the internet, don't you think all the companies out there would need somebody who has a digital marketing skill for them to be able to create more funnels for them to be able to utilize taking traffic to their products and services, to their sales pages? Yes. If you have any sort of digital marketing skill which allows you to bring in revenue for the company, bring in profit, and the best part about all these skills that I'm saying, all of this adds value to the bottom line and the top line of any business, any entrepreneur, any companies. And if you are acquiring the skill of copywriting, digital marketing skill, or high ticket closing, you're essentially becoming a person who is adding bottom line, who is adding top line to a company. So in any kind of an economy, people will always look to increase their revenue. People will always look to increase their profits, top line, bottom line, yes or no? If that's the case, if you have the skill, don't you think you will always be in demand? If you have these high income skills like copywriting, digital marketing, high ticket closing, you will always be in demand and you will always be in charge of your personal economy. That's the first powerful method that I am just speaking about. Acquiring high income skills. Ask yourself, what are the high income skills that I can acquire within me, even if I'm doing my current job in sales, in SM, in operation, in anything, even if I'm an HR, whether I'm doing a business, real estate business, e-commerce business, brick and mortar shop, what are the high income skills that I need to develop for me to take charge of my own personal economy? Remember, all these skills are learnable. How many of you understand this particular point? How many of you are with me on this? And if you are with me on this and you are going to make sure that you implement on this, mention hell yeah in the comment box. Mention hell yeah in the comment box. Welcome Nikhilesh, welcome Deepa, welcome Krishnaveni, welcome Sudhir, welcome Deepa, welcome Akshay. Mention hell yeah in the chat box. Acquiring high income skills allows any kind of a professional today, any kind of a professional, for them to always be in charge of your own personal economy. That's the first powerful method to be able to become a person who has a charge of their own personal economy, no matter what kind of economy goes on in the entire world, in your country. If you're with me on this, mention hell yeah. Mention hell yeah in the comment box. Mention hell yeah. That's the first powerful method. The second powerful method for you to be in charge of your own personal economy, and listen to this carefully, is called creating a business around what you do best in life. Creating a business around what you do best in life. It means creating a business around a certain skill, around a certain domain area, around a certain expertise which you are best in. For example, today, a lot of people believe or like to believe that, you know what, Ravneet, you're talking about creating a business around a particular skill, a particular domain area, a particular expertise. But I don't even know what is my expertise. I don't even know if I have a skill which I can create a business around. Because most people are not even aware that they can utilize the current skill, current domain expertise in any area, which I'm going to talk about more. They don't even realize that they have a skill which they can monetize, which they can create a business around. That's the reason they are not even taking the first step. So let me take an example. You might think you have no skills in your life. You might think you have no expertise. Tell me one thing. Are there people in your life who are coming to you for any sort of advices in your life? Are there people in your life who are coming to you for some sort of advice which these people are coming only to you? Maybe regards to anything in life. Maybe regards to, let's say, relationship. Maybe regards to finances. Maybe regards to health. Maybe regards to spirituality. Maybe regards to anything. Please understand. Understand that today, in this world, if you want to take charge of your own personal economy, you got to become a person who is identifying a problem in the market and who is giving a solution. Who is identifying a problem in the market and who is giving a solution. Now, do you believe that you have a solution? Maybe, maybe not. But I will prove it to you right now that you have some sort of solution within you which you're not even aware of. For example, today you are 20 years of age, 25 years of age, 30 years of age, 35 years of age, 40 years of age, 45 years. Today you have lived a certain life by now. If you have lived a certain life, have you gone through certain life experiences? Absolutely yes. If you have gone through certain life experiences, have you come across various challenges in your life? Absolutely yes. If you have come across various challenges in your life, have you overcome those challenges? Absolutely yes. If you have overcome those challenges, don't you think that is something that you can help other people who are going through the same challenges? For example, let's say you have gone through a very toxic relationship in your life. Let's say you were married and you have gone through a certain toxic relationship in your life. But you have overcome that toxic relationship and today you are happily married with somebody else. Let's say you have gone through a certain toxic relationship in your life and you have overcome that. Is this not a skill? Is this not something that you can help other people with? Absolutely yes. Can you create a product? Can you create a service around it? Can you create an online course? Can you create a digital course? Can you create a certain coaching service? Can you create a certain consulting service? Can you create a business around what you do best?
Absolutely yes. Think about it. Let's say you have given a try for you to start businesses in the past, but you have failed. But you have failed. You have tried to create business. You have tried to become an entrepreneur, but you have failed. But today you are a successful businessman. Is this not a skill? Can you not teach other people who have been failing in trying to set up their businesses in a particular industry, in a particular niche? Can you not help these people? If yes, can you not reduce their timeline of making it big? Would these people pay you? Absolutely yes. Why? Because it is a problem. Today, anybody and everybody out there is having a certain problem, and if you have a solution for it, can you create a business around it? Absolutely yes. The first thing which is going to stop you is your own mindset. Ravneet, I'm not even aware if I have a certain skill. I am saying you have. Maybe you're not aware. Today in this world, I'll tell you, there are weird things. There are weird problems for which people are paying money to somebody who can solve the problem. Let me give one example. Are there people out there who are facing a huge problem of having a quality sleep at night? Are there people out there who are facing huge issues in terms of having a quality sleep? They can't sleep they can't sleep properly. They're not getting quality sleep, because of which they are waking up tired, because of which there is less energy, because of which their productivity gets hampered, because of which their career gets hampered, job gets hampered, business gets hampered. Is this a problem in the market? Absolutely yes. Let's say you're a person who knows how to have quality sleep. Let's say you're a person who have mastered the art of sleeping in a quality way in your own life. Can you not create a certain process? Can you not create a certain system around helping other people to be able to sleep in a quality way? Would these people pay you? Absolutely yes, because it's not a small thing. It's a very big thing. Why? Because not being able to sleep properly affects every single area of your life. That is the reason today so many people are helping other people to become trainers, to become coaches. Why? Because the only method that many people are deploying other people to become trainers and coaches is this. You have a problem, can you give a solution? And if you can give a solution, you can create a business around it, you can monetize this. You don't need to become a coach, but essentially you are becoming a coach, because whether you look at it as a coach, or you look at it as a mentor, or you look at it as anything. Today, if you're in a job, when you're in a job, today if you're a manager, if you're a CEO, if you're a director of sales, are you not mentoring other people, other sales professionals who are below you to be able to become better at sales? Is that not mentoring? Is that not coaching? Can you, if you have got certain skills within you, can you not create a business around it separately? Yes, you can. I am saying the second skill that anybody can learn and anybody can master for you to be able to take charge of your own personal economy is creating a business around what you do best in life. And I'm telling you, there is certain skill, there is a certain problem, there is a certain challenge that each one of us have gone through. Each one of us, sabki story is life mein, every person have gone through certain kind of situations in their life. Every person have gone through certain kind of experiences in their life. Every person have gone through certain kind of challenges in their life. And if you have overcome the challenges, is that not a problem? Are you the only person who's going through that challenge? There are 7.8 billion people. You will easily find hundreds and millions, thousands and millions of people who are going through the same problem. What am I doing today? Tell me, what am I doing today? I created a business around what I do best in life, on mental toughness. Because I've gone through certain situations in my life which allowed me to be mentally tough. And I created a system, I created a process, and people are paying me huge money for them to be able to learn what I have learned and how I can help them. How am I doing? Now you might think, Ravneet, because you're into coaching industry, don't look at it as a coaching industry. It's a problem, I'm giving a solution. That's it. Anybody can create a business. In fact, there are people out there who are paying in India as well. In India and in America and in many European countries in any way. There are people out there who have a problem, and there are parents who do not know how to change nappies of newborn kids. They do not know how to handle and manage a newborn kid. And they are taking classes from somebody who knows how to manage and how to handle newborn babies. They are paying money to them because this is a problem out there. This is a problem. Please understand, in any economy, even if economy goes for a toss, people might reduce their spend on luxury items. People might reduce their spend on anything which they can postpone for tomorrow. Maybe anything, maybe buying a car, maybe buying a house, maybe anything which is considered as a luxury or as a want. But people will always be willing to pay for a problem, a big enough problem. People will always be willing to pay for a problem no matter what you are going through. If you can identify a problem and you have a solution for it, can you not create a business around it? The only thing is you got to learn how to do it, how to monetize it, how to create a structure, how to create a system. But I'm saying every one of you out there can create a certain part-time business, if not even a full-time business, a part-time business on what you do best in. The only thing which is again going to stop you is your mental limitations, your mental block. Kon kare, kon seekhe, hoga hi nahi. It is not the case. I also used to work in corporate world. Since last 5 years now, I have been helping people. How am I doing that? I've also learned, right? Today, there are hundreds and thousands of people who have gone through my programs, who have gone through my workshops, who have gone through my webinars for them to be able to achieve the results. I never thought that I would be a person who would even speak to 10 people in my life, because if some of you have gone through my live workshops or webinars or you know me in any way, through any which way, any platform, you would know my teenage life was a very hard life. And I never thought that I would be able to even face people. I was such an underconfident child. I was such a confused child. I was so nervous. I had no self-confidence. What am I doing today? How come this has happened? Am I the only person? No. There are hundreds and millions of people who have done it in their life, who have gone through various challenges, and there are hundreds and millions of people who are doing it right now. I'm not the first person, okay? Is duniya mein bahut saare log aa chuke hain, bahut saare log kar chuke hain, abhi bhi kar rahe hain aur future mein bhi hoga. The only thing which is going to stop you is your mindset. That's the reason the first thing that I teach people when I teach people is mental toughness. And then I teach how mental toughness can help you in your finances, in your health, and in your relationship. But the first thing always starts here. If you only convince yourself it's not going to happen, it is never going to happen. Today, in any kind of an economy, if you can identify a problem and you can give a solution, which you can, there is a certain solution which you have as a skill, which you are not aware of, but you can figure out and you can monetize. If you can create a business around what you do best in life, don't you think you will be always be in charge of your personal economy? No matter what economy is going on, if you can identify and address certain problems of people, look at this way, guys. Everybody out there is trying to better their life in one way or the other. They're trying to better their life in luxury, in convenience, in comfort, in wealth, in health, in relationship. If everybody is trying to better their life experience, in one way or the other, are they not looking for solutions to their problems? If they're looking for solutions to their problems, don't you think that maybe you would also have a certain solution which people would have come to you? The best way to just think about that, what you can do best in, or what is the skill that you have, ask yourself, which is the kind of thing where people are coming to me most for the advices? Are people coming to you for certain kind of advices? Are various kinds of people are coming to you for certain kind of advices because they think you are the best person who can help them? Maybe you can take that thing and make a business out of it. But you need to learn the how part, how to do it. But I am saying you can create a business for something that you are best in, and you are best in something. That's the second method for you to be always in charge of your personal economy, guys. No matter what is going on, if you can create a business around what you do best in life, it allows you to be able to print your own money. And I'm saying it in a literal way, to print your own money, because problem is already there and people will always pay for the problem. No matter what is going on, they might sacrifice even on their needs, but they will always pay for a big enough problem. Please understand this point. Second point is creating a business around what you do best in life. If you're with me on this, mention yes. Mention yes in the chat box. You gave me a wonderful idea, Maninder Singh, fantastic, on solving problems. Can we charge high prices for solving problems? Absolutely yes. You can always charge high prices for solving problems if the problem is big enough and you also know how to market yourself. So I'm going to talk about the third and fourth step, which allows you to charge more for your services, for your solution. But if you're with me on this and you're understanding what I'm saying, mention yes in the chat box. Mention yes in the chat box. Supinder, Piyush, Vibhor, mention yes in the chat box. I've spoken about two powerful methods till now. The first powerful method is acquiring high income skills. The second powerful method is creating a business around what you do best in life. If you do these two things, you will always be in charge of your personal economy. It takes some effort, it takes some time. But duniya mein koi magic pill nahi hai. Kaam karna padta hai har cheez ke liye. Isliye pehle ye jo change ka brain hai na, isko control mein lana padega. Jab tak ye control mein nahi aayega, and I'm going to talk about the last income skill later on, tab tak kuch nahi hoga. So these are two methods that I've spoken about for you to be in charge of your own personal economy. What's the third method? The third method is creating a personal brand. Creating a personal brand for yourself, no matter what you're doing in your life. Creating a personal brand, no matter what you're doing in your life. Let me give you an example. Today, no matter guys, what profession you are in, what kind of an occupation you are in, whether you're in a job, whether you're a business, whether you're an actor, whether you're an artist, whether you're a sportsman, whether you're a politician, whether you're a spiritual guru, whether you're a coach, whether you are anybody. In today's world, you got to create a personal brand for yourself. Because if you do not create a personal brand for yourself, when the economy gets tough, you will be the person who will be in the firing line of being fired in your job. You will be in the firing line when clients are not coming to you and giving you their business. They're going to a person or they're going to a business who has a bigger market value, who has a bigger brand than your business. So let me explain. Why do you need to create a personal brand no matter who you are? A lot of people think, Ravneet, why do I need to create a personal brand? I'm working in a corporate company. I'm a coder. I'm a sales professional. I'm a SCM guy. I'm a HR guy. And I'm sending my resumes out there and I'm getting a job. Imagine yourself today. Let's say along with you, there's another person who has equal skills as you have. Your resume and his resume in terms of skills are equal. And both of you apply for a certain kind of a job. But the other person has certain sort of a personal brand. If the other person has certain sort of a personal brand, what do I mean by personal brand? Let's say you're applying for a sales job. Okay. Both of you have equal skills in terms of skills, in terms of your experience, in terms of what you have done, which you put across in a Word document, which you put across in a PDF document, and you send it across to a prospective employer. But the other person also has a personal brand, which means, let's say, one of the ways to create a personal brand is to create a digital identity. Let's say this person has a YouTube channel. For example, small thing I'm saying. Let's say this person has a YouTube channel. This person has a Facebook page. This person has an Instagram page or anything, a certain sort of digital identity. This person on his page, on his digital media platform, he's creating content in terms of videos as to, you know what, five mistakes most people make when they are closing sales with a client. Six mistakes or six differences between B2B and B2C sales. Five powerful methods for you to get a first meeting with a client. Let's say he's creating some sort of content out there in terms of videos, in terms of text, in terms of gifs, in terms of memes, in terms of articles. He's creating some sort of content. And along with his resume, he also shows about and talks about, this is what I do for me. He's showing himself as an expert out there that, you know what, I'm not just applying for companies and getting a job. I have a certain sort of digital identity as well. If you are an employer, ask yourself, if you are an employer and you have two people who are there in front of you, both of them are equal in all the skills, but one person has a certain sort of digital identity. He has built a certain sort of brand. He has written articles. He has put some videos out there, which shows him as a credible authority, which shows him as an expert. Won't you look at this person a different way? Yes or no? Mention yes if you will. Won't you look at this person a different way? Absolutely yes. Won't this person would be in a leveraged position even before sitting across a negotiation table with you? Absolutely yes. Most people today, when they apply for a job, they are into a fearful position. Mereko job mil jaye, ya mereko itna CTC mil jaye. You're always dependent upon the other person to decide your salary. If you are a personal brand, in even small ways, won't you be in a leveraged position and you get to decide your CTC? Because you will be in a leveraged position. You will demand and you will get the CTC because you are into a position where you can actually speak about what you need to do. Because the other person will also look at you differently. You are having a hold of that negotiation meeting. Most people are playing on the defensive. They are not on the offensive. Why? Because you have not done something which allows you to be on the offensive. If you today are a businessman, today look at this. There are so many companies out there who have great products, great services. But they are still not a market leader. They are still not having the market share of that industry. Why? The reason being, they have not created a personal brand for the business. Ask yourself today, there are companies out there who are selling mobile phones from a range of 500 rupees to a range of 1 lakh rupees, 1.5 lakh rupees. Why do people pay 1 lakh rupees, 1.5 lakh rupees for Apple phone? At the end of the day, it's just a phone. Yes, there might be certain features here and there which allows Apple to be looked at differently. But do you as a consumer, do you really have such a big reason, apart from one reason, for you to pay a premium of, let's say, 95,000 rupees? You can buy a phone, smartphone, of 5,000 rupees as well. Almost same features, almost do the same functionalities. But you pay 1 lakh rupees for an Apple iPhone. You know why? Because when you own an Apple iPhone, you're not owning a product. You're owning a brand. When you see an Apple iPhone and that logo at the back, which is logo at the back, it is like a social status for most people. It's like a social status. You're not buying a product, you're buying a brand. Lamborghini, Gucci bags, all of these are what? Brand. Today, there are so many brick and mortar shops. These are kirane ki dukane hoti hai. Ye kahin na kahin jaake, if they don't make a personal brand out of themselves, they're going to be extinguished. They're going to be moved out of the market. You know why? Because supermarkets like Haiko, D-Mart, all of these have created personal brands for themselves, which means they can leverage, they can charge more premiums, they can demand a higher premium on their products and services. Do you go and negotiate with those people for the products and services? You don't. You would negotiate on a thela wala. Thela wala se negotiate karoge, par kabhi brand se negotiate nahi karoge. Kyun? Wahan pe ek issue aata hai negotiate karne ka. Why? Because they are a personal brand. Ask yourself, in your job today, no matter what job, what business, if you're an actor, ask yourself, are there actors out there who are having great acting skills, fantastic acting skills, but they are still not earning the money which some of the actors that other actors are earning? Some of them who are mediocre actors, mediocre acting skills? Yes. Why? Because people who have great acting skills, they are not focused on one thing, which is making a personal brand out of themselves. In this world, you might have a great product, you might have a great service, you might be the fantastic guy in your domain, in your area, but if you don't know how to sell yourself, if you don't make a personal brand out of yourself, you will never be in charge of your personal economy. But if you make a personal brand out of yourself, would you be the first person or even the last person to be fired from your job in difficult times? No, you will not, because you're also a personal brand. The way people look at you, the way companies look at you, the way potential clients look at you is in a different way. If you are a brand, you will always get clients even in downturn. If you are a brand, you will always have another job to look after. People will keep hiring you if you are a brand in your industry. If you are an IT guy, make a brand for yourself in IT industry. You can. There are various ways to it. But all I'm saying is, on a macro level, if you create a personal brand out of yourself in any kind of an economy, will you be short of jobs? Will you be short of potential clients? Absolutely not. People will always give you money, either in a salary or either in your business. They will always come to you. They will always hire, take your products and services because you are a personal brand out there. Cricketers. There are so many cricketers out there who are earning money, not through cricket, not through BCCI. They're earning money through BCCI. But many of these people are earning money because they're personal brand, because of endorsement, because of advertisements, because of going to certain functions. They charge huge money. When people write books, J.K. Rowling, if you know the name of this Harry Potter author, J.K. Rowling, J.K. Rowling has not earned her fortune because of writing a book. Nobody becomes rich by writing a book. People become rich by making a brand. Today, J.K. Rowling, because she's a brand, Hollywood directors have taken her script, create movies out of it, and she's earning a royalty income. The only reason she's getting a royalty income because she has created a brand out of herself. In today's world, 7.8 billion people, everybody needs to become a brand. Agar aap apna thela bhi chala rahe ho na, there is a way that you can become a brand. Kuch bhi kar rahe ho, you need to become a brand. When you become a brand, you will always be in charge of your own personal economy. How many of you understand this and you think that this makes a lot of sense? If this makes a lot of sense, mention it makes sense in the comment box. Mention it makes sense in the comment box. Marinder, Ashwini, Sandeep, mention it makes sense in the comment box. Till now, I've spoken about three powerful methods for you to create your own personal economy. First, acquiring high income skills. Second, making sure that you create a business around what you do best in life. And the third is creating a personal brand out there, no matter what you do. The fourth powerful method I'm going to give it to you today for you to create your own personal economy is to be able to become more valuable in the marketplace. What do I mean by that? Let's say today you work in a job. A lot of people believe that only if you're a sales professional in any corporate company, you add on to the top line and you add on to the bottom line of your respective company. People think only sales professionals add on to the top line and the bottom line of a company. Absolutely not. Even if you're an HR guy, let's say you're an HR guy, are you not adding to the top line, bottom line? How you can add on to the top line, bottom line? Let's say your job is to hire people. If you can hire people at a less cost with respect to the expertise that they have, are you not saving money for your company? Absolutely yes. If you're saving money, every penny saved is a penny earned. You're adding on to the overall balance sheet of a company. If you're into marketing department And if you can bring quality leads, quality prospects at a lesser marketing cost for your respective company, are you not saving money? Are you not adding to the bottom line? Can you, as a marketer in your company, can you make use of digital mediums? Can you make use of Facebook campaigns? Can you make use of social media campaigns for you to bring in quality leads for your company to be able to convert those leads at a lesser cost? Are you not adding to the profit? Are you not adding to the top line and the bottom line? Yes, you are. Most people, when they are today doing their jobs or they are running their businesses, the first thing that they're not thinking about, which is the best thing and the first important thing that you should think about for you to be able to take charge of your personal economy is, are you asking yourself as an employee today, how are you becoming more valuable for your company? How are you becoming more valuable for your department? How are you becoming more valuable for your boss? Are you asking yourself, am I acquiring enough skills for me to be able to complement my existing skills? Are you thinking of ways to become more valuable in the marketplace as an employee? As a businessman, are you thinking of ways to become more valuable in the marketplace? Are you thinking of ways to be able to increase customer stickiness so that customer is stick with you no matter what new product come out in the market, what new services come out in the market, because you have customer stickiness, and customer stickiness will come if you're always thinking about adding value. There are various ways through which you can add value. Let's say you're a businessman. Can you not think of ways, let's say through services? If you have a customer support, if you have a services department, can you not add value through your customer support, through your services department? Because adding value through services and customer support, if you have a full-time customer support team, is always an extra effort. Can you not think of discounting certain products? Can you not think of coming up with a certain package for you to give certain kind of products at a lesser cost? Making a package. I'm asking is, can you not think of ways to add more value into your company as an employee? Can you not think of ways to add more value to your respective clients as a businessman? Once you start becoming more valuable in the marketplace, don't you think in any kind of an economy, people will always give you business? People will always make sure that they are not firing you. People will always make sure that they're upgrading you in your corporate career. If you're more valuable to your company, absolutely yes. What people do is, you're getting 50,000 rupees, aap utna hi kaam karoge, itna 50,000 mil raha hai. Nahin. As a coach today, this is what my rule is. If somebody invests any amount of money, if they invest 1 rupees, I need to give them 10x of value, minimum, 10x of value. If today you are into any sort of a job, any sort of a business, if you are paid any amount of money through your company or through your clients, are you asking yourself, how am I giving back? How am I becoming more valuable? Am I giving 10x of the value? Because you're not asking yourself, you will never be in charge of your personal economy, because when times get tough, clients will move away. When times get tough, your companies will fire you. When times get tough, your company will come up with an excuse. Ravneet, the economy is tough. We cannot promote you. This is what the economic situation is. But if you are becoming more valuable to your company, they will still allow you to get higher salary, and they will not going to do that for other people, because you're a valuable asset to a company. Most people are not even thinking about becoming an asset for a company. They're just doing their jobs. If you are into business, you're just serving your customers minimal. Companies out there, businesses out there who are having market share, who are the dominant leader in the industry, are the companies, are the businesses who are always thinking of adding more value into the marketplace. Because the more you become valuable in the marketplace, in any economy, because you're valuable, you will always get money. You will always be in charge of your cash inflow. You will always be in charge of your finances, your financial growth, because you are becoming irreplaceable. You're becoming kind of irreplaceable in the market because you are more valuable. Let me give an example today. And don't mind me taking this example, because I take examples from various industries, various professions, various areas. Today, you might hate the leader of this country. Okay, because all of us can have different point of view, guys. Do not start hating me just because I'm going to speak about this person. You might hate that person, you might not like that person, whatever, because we all can have different viewpoints because we are living in a democracy. But today, I'm telling you, if there's a survey which is done in India, across India, and if they have to think of an alternative leader to run this country, they cannot come up with a name. Because the person who is running this country right now, he has made himself so much valuable in the marketplace. People cannot even think of replacing him. You know why? Because he's always looking at adding more value. You might not agree with that. That's completely okay. But look at the majority of the population. And you don't have to hate me for that, okay? We all can have different opinions. I'm saying, are you thinking of becoming more valuable in the marketplace? Are you thinking of becoming more valuable in your respective company, in your job, in your domain, in your expertise? Are you thinking of how can I make sure that I'm 10x valuable to my clients, every single customer that I'm serving? And if you start thinking about that way and you come up with various ways, marketing ways, sales ways, package, services, customer support, acquiring new skills in your job. If you're a sales professional, ask yourself, how can I become more valuable to my company? Are there new skills that I can bring into my foray, bring into my armory for me to become more valuable in the marketplace? One mind will stop you telling you, yeah, mere paas to itna salary hai, main to nahi karunga. No, you are creating your own personal economy, guys. You will become irreplaceable. And there are very few people who do that. Imagine, once you start thinking on these lines, imagine, would you not be in charge of your own personal economy at any given time? Absolutely yes. So what are the four methods that I spoke about today for you to be in charge of your own personal economy? The first method I spoke about is acquiring high income skills. These skills are always going to be there in any kind of a economy. These skills are always going to be in demand. Some of these skills will earn you minimum 1 lakh rupees if you do certain things right starting today. If you can do certain things right, maybe in a few months time, through these skills, even if you're into a job, even if you're into a business, through these skills, you will always be in demand as a freelancer. What are those skills? Copywriting. I spoke about copywriting. I spoke about digital marketing. I spoke about high ticket closing. If you have joined in late, I would suggest you to go through the live video once again so that you can go through the explanation that I gave on these skills. Acquiring high income skills allows you to be in charge of your own personal economy. Second thing, creating a business around what you do best in life. And there is something that you do best in life. If you can figure out a problem in the market and you can come up with a solution which you have today, there is a certain skill, there is a certain area, there is a certain expertise that you have which you might not be aware of. The only thing you got to do is you got to identify that skill and you got to create a business. The only thing which is going to stop you, again, Ravni, mujhe pata hai nahi skill kya hai. You can always find out their skill. One of the tip that I gave you, if there are people who are coming to you for advices on the same topic, same issue, over and over again, maybe the reason people are coming to advices on this particular topic with you because you're the person who gives the best advices. You're the person who helps these people in their situation. So if you can create a business around what you do best in life, and anybody can do that, you are in charge of your personal economy. Third thing, creating a personal brand, no matter who you are. If you are a personal brand out there in the market, no matter what profession you are in, no matter what you're doing, you will always be in demand because personal branding allows you to be in charge of your personal economy. People will not fire you. People will always give you jobs. People will always give you higher salaries. People will always come to you as customers because you're a personal brand out there. Even if you own a business, don't make your business as a brand. Make yourself as a brand. There are so many people out there who are running their businesses. Their business is moving to the next stage, not because of the brand of the business, but because of the personal brand. Google is moving because of Google. People don't even know the names of the people who have come up with Google. But many of the companies out there are moving ahead, and I can give you so many examples because of that person who has created a personal brand. And the future always lies in personal branding. Even if you're a businessman, do not create a brand around your business. Create a brand around you, because today you are your brand. You are your business. You are your economy. If you don't create a personal brand, and I'm being very serious, it does not allow you to be in charge of your personal economy. And the fourth step that I spoke about is ask yourself how to become more valuable in the marketplace. The more valuable you become in your respective field, in your respective profession, as a businessman, in your industry, as an actor, as an artist, you will always be in charge of your own personal economy. So these are four steps or four methods that I have given you in detail for you to start working upon starting today. All of these are implementable, are real. The only thing which is going to stop you is again your mindset. So let me tell you what is the biggest high income skill that you got to learn. Biggest high income skill. I've spoken about three income skills, high income skills, and there are many more. But I'll tell you the biggest high income skill. The biggest high income skill is your mindset skill, is your mental toughness. Because a lot of people know what they need to do, but they can't get themselves to do it because of laziness, because of procrastination, because of mental blocks, because of lack of self-belief, because of lack of confidence, because of self-sabotage, because of a lot of things which they cannot control because they have no idea how to take charge of their mindset. Why am I helping people? The first thing is changing mindset. Why am I helping people, first of all, to change their mindset, to become mentally tough, and then I teach them on finances and health and relationship. Why? Because I know everything starts here and everything ends here. No matter how many times I repeat this, in any of my interactions with people out there, my live sessions, my workshops, my webinars, anything, I will repeat this again and again, because that's where everything starts, guys, and that's where everything ends. The world is not suffering on the outside. People are suffering inside because they have no mechanism, no system, no processes to take charge of their mindset. Is the reason people are suffering in finances? Is the reason people are not consistent in their health? Is the reason people don't know how to manage relationship? Is the reason you're not able to build your businesses? Is the reason you're not able to move ahead in your career? So everything starts with mindset. That's the high income scale that you got to learn. So with this, I've come to the end. I hope this session has added value into your life. If this session has added value into your life, think about it. Am I becoming more valuable in the marketplace by giving all these strategies, amazing strategies, which I share with people who are part of my inner circle? I'm giving you these amazing strategies free of cost. Am I becoming more valuable in the marketplace? Absolutely yes. Ask yourself, yes or no? Please ask yourself, let's be very honest. What am I doing? I'm becoming more valuable for my market out there by doing these free sessions. Please understand them. And this is with all right intentions you do that, because if you are going to help people, you got to help people in various ways. I know for the fact that sometimes people are not able to come into my coaching programs because of various reasons. But if I can reach out to you and help you in any which way, I would do that no matter what it is. And if you are a person who really wants to take it to the next level, really wants to go to the next level, you will find a way to be able to get in touch with somebody who can help you. It might not be me, it might be somebody else. You might not connect with me. You might not connect. But if you want to change any part of your life, you might connect with somebody else. Connect with anybody. If you have a problem, there is somebody out there who can give you a solution. So I hope this session has added value into your life. If this session has added value to your life, mention yes, huge yes in the chat box. Mention huge yes in the chat box. Maninder Singh is saying, "Bahut vadhiya Ravneet, it's first time I watched your video. You made me your fan." Thank you, Maninder. I'm your fan too. Dheeraj Tiwari, please suggest some goods which covers all these things to go in detail. Dheeraj, I would want you to be very specific with your question. I did not understood your question. Amazing, Ravneet. Ashwini is saying that. Fantastic. Abhishek, fantastic. Amazing ideas, advices. Keep it up. If you have any question, please go ahead and ask. Fantastic. Yes. I'm seeing a lot of yes. If you have any questions, please go ahead and ask. By the way, tomorrow morning, I'm doing a free session, a free webinar on mental toughness. Tomorrow morning from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m., I'm doing a free session on mental toughness as to how mental toughness will help you succeed in finances, health, and relationship. A 2-hour powerful webinar. It's a free webinar. I'm going to give a link after the end of this live call. When I'm going to publish this live call, I'm going to mention that link in the description box. If you want to be a part of tomorrow's free webinar and you want to go through how mental toughness can help you succeed in finances, health, and relationship, you can go ahead and register yourself. So tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. to 12 p.m., I'm doing a free webinar. If you want to, please go ahead and register yourself through the link that I'm going to give it to you once I publish this live video. Okay, so let me answer a few questions now. Vibhor Jain is asking, which is the best way to learn digital marketing, online or offline? Would you recommend any courses? Vibhor, there are multiple people who might be teaching digital marketing out there. See, there are three ways, Vibhor, through which you can learn anything. Listen to my three ways. The first way is you can learn anything and everything by your own. So today, if you want to learn digital marketing, go through Google, do your research, do all of that stuff, go through trial and error, learn on your own. Now, there is no harm in learning on your own, but if you learn on your own, what it does is, it costs you effort, a lot of effort, and it costs you a lot of time, which essentially costs you a lot of money. People might not look at it that way, but cost of effort and cost of time is equal to money, and you might still not be able to get it. So one way is to do it on your own, okay? Second way is to learn it from some of the people that you know as your friends, as your colleagues, jo thoda jante hain, aaspaas. Again, you can do that. You can learn from the colleagues, you can learn from some of the people that you know. But essentially, if some of these people are part of your circle and some of these people are at your level in that field, these are not the best people who can help you to learn a specific skill. The best way to learn is to learn from people who are a master, who are an expert. So what I would suggest you is this: find out certain people out there in India, and there are so many people out there. You'll find out there are so many people out there who are offering courses, online courses, offline courses. You decide I am saying hire somebody who is a mentor, hire somebody who is a coach in digital marketing. And in digital marketing also choose a particular skill, because digital marketing is huge. You got to choose one skill. You decide out of so many skills that I spoke about, which is skill that interests you. If you don't know what is interest, start learning on a macro perspective. Once you start learning different skills, just like when you were a student, you went through class 1 to class 8 to 9th. In 10th, you either chose science or commerce or your art. And once you chose, you decided later on what exactly you need to pursue. So start doing everything. Start learning a bit of everything in digital marketing and see where does your interest lie. If you see that this is something that your interest lie, pursue that. So the best way to learn digital marketing or anything in life is to find out. Do some research, because when you hire somebody as a coach or expert, what it does is this, the best part. And I'm not saying because I am a coach, so I'm recommending. And I have my own coaches in my life. I'll tell you one thing. Whether you take it as a coach or a mentor, first of all, I really like the word guru, because in our ancient India, we never used to use this term called mentor or coach. It's a Western term. We used to have guru. Even Pandavas had guru. Krishna ji had gurus. Chhatrapati Shivaji Maurya had a guru. Each of these people had a guru in their life. In fact, in our ancient India, almost every person had a guru. Why? Because a guru allows you to be able to reduce your timeline. A guru allows you to not make the mistakes which they would have made. So if you want to learn digital marketing and you want to reduce your timeline, hire somebody who knows what they are doing and pay them for their courses, learn through them so that you learn faster, you learn from the mistake, and you don't have to go through trial and error. So to answer your question, the best way to learn is to learn from somebody. So do your research in terms of which are the people who are doing great in digital marketing, and then go about taking their courses or ask for the help, ask for the support. That's the best way, according to me, that you should do, because it reduces your timeline. You would have to pay money, which you should pay, because you're learning something which is going to help you, but that's the best way. So I hope, Vibhor, I have been able to answer your question. If I have, mention yes, Ravneet, in the chat box. Mention yes, Ravneet, in the chat box. Please suggest some good books. Dheeraj Tiwari. Dheeraj, if you can be specific about which subjects that you're asking for, which kind of books that you're asking for, which subjects, then I can suggest you something. So be specific about certain topics or subjects. Can you throw some more light on copywriting? Sukhinder Bawa. Sukhinder, what is copywriting? Let me explain once more. Copywriting is nothing but today, anything that you see in form of advertisements, in form of any marketing material, promotional material, anything which is being sold in the market today, right from a small needle to an aeroplane, is being sold through marketing, through promotion, yes or no? If anything is being sold through marketing or promotional or any kind of a medium which allows you to be able to see that product, see that services, all of this is in some form of written content, written text. That written content, that written text is nothing called copy. So today, whenever you see any ad advertisements on Facebook, whatever is written, which is in the form of text, is nothing but a copy. There are people out there, there are companies, businesses out there who hire people how to create this copy. Any sales letter that you see is copy. Any landing pages that you see is copy. Any banner ad that you see is copy. Anything which is in the form of written content, which is attracting certain customers, certain potential clients for their products and services, is nothing but copy. Your resume is also your copy, because you're trying to project yourself in the best way possible through a written form of content. So if you want to have a great resume, can you hire a copywriter who can project yourself in the best way possible? Yes. Today, if you send proposals as a sales professional for your company, when you create a proposal, what you are doing, you're writing something, it's a written form of content, it is nothing but a copy. Today, you have come to this Facebook Live. Why you have come to this Facebook Live? You have come because the topic attracted you. How to create your own personal economy. Learn 4 powerful methods to be able to be in charge of your personal economy. What is this? It attracts an audience. It is copy. So in any kind of an economy, Sukhinder, people will always have a demand to sell their products and services. If they have a requirement to sell their products and services, they will always need somebody who can do some form of marketing, some form of promotion. All this marketing promotion will always be in some form of written content. Even video sales letter is in form of written content. It is nothing but copy. Copy, text. So anything which is requiring you to create a certain form of written content is copywriting. So in any kind of an economy, if you have a copywriting skill, would you always be in demand? Absolutely yes, because companies, businesses, entrepreneurs hire copywriters and they pay them very, very high income. Because at the end of the day, copywriting adds on to their bottom line, adds on to their top line, revenue, profit. So I hope that answers your question, Sukhvinder. If yes, mention yes, Ravneet, in the chat box. Thank you, Vibhor. What are the ideas that lesser fear and provide power do action? So Prabhodan is asking a different question. So let me just answer this question. Essentially, your question is how to overcome fear. So Prabhodan, I'm going to give you a short answer. And there's a real answer which is there. But so let me give both the answer, the real answer and the short answer. I'll give you a real answer. Okay. And you might not get this answer right now. You might not get this answer. You might not understand, but I will still say it. The real answer is, in this world, we have all been made to believe right from our childhood that we all have some sort of fear in our life. Nobody is fearless. We all have been taught everybody has fear, everybody has fear, everybody has fear. Fear is a ingrained part of being a human being. If you are a human being, if you have emotions, obviously you will have fear. People have fear about various things. People have fear about closed spaces. People have fear about heights. People have fear about applying for something but getting rejected. People have fear about various things. What I am saying is, this is a real answer, and for you to get this real answer, I'll tell you what you need to move towards for you to get this real answer. Then I will give you a short answer, an answer which most people give, and I'm also going to give that. But this is a real answer. In this world, a human being, any human being, is not supposed to have any fear, because all fears are self-created. Any kind of a fear is self-created by our own mind. But because we have been made to condition right from our childhood through videos, through Google, through successful people, through motivational speakers, through anybody, successful people, they say, fear drives me, fear drives me, fear drives me. All of these fears are self-created. Are there things in your life where you thought that this is going to happen? You had a fear of something will happen, but that fear will never came true. Ask yourself in your life, out of 100 fears that you have had in your life, I'm telling you, 90% of those fears or 95% of those fears never came true, which only tells you that most of these fears were self-created. And the fears which came true were also self-created. We create fears in our own mind. And for you to understand this, you got to become more spiritual in your life. You got to become more spiritual in your life. You got to have more understanding about life itself. I cannot cover the spiritual part right now. That's the reason I said, this is the real answer. You will not get this real answer from anybody. In fact, as a coach, I should not even speak like this. Because as a coach, what do people expect? People expect, give me an answer which most people give kind of a stuff. Ravneet, sabke andar fear hai. Main bol raha hu koi fear hai nahi. Now you can ask me a counter question. Ravneet, does that mean, today, obviously, if you're talking about this, which means you're a spiritual person in some way, yes, I am. You might also ask, Ravneet, are you meaning that you have reached a stage in life where you're completely fearless? If you're saying this, so my answer is not yet, but I have moved to a stage where very shortly, and I'm working on that, where I would never have any fear in my life. I'm working on it since last two years. I've gotten into spirituality, I've gotten into this space, and I'm going to add even the spirituality part as part of my coaching program. Today there are three aspects that I cover: health, wealth and relationship. I'm also going to cover spirituality going ahead once I master it. I have not mastered it. इसलिए मैं अभी पढ़ाता नहीं हूं. जब तक मैं मास्टर नहीं करूंगा तब तक नहीं करूंगा. टुडे आई हैव नॉट रीच्ड अ स्टेज वेयर आई एम कंप्लीटली फियरलेस, बट आई हैव मूव्ड टू अ स्टेज इन लास्ट इयर्स वेयर आई हार्डली हैव एनी फियर्स. दिस इज द रियल आंसर. आई कैन नॉट गो मोर डीप इनटू इट बिकॉज आई नीड टू हैव मोर टाइम. बट ऑल फियर्स आर क्रिएटेड बाय आवर माइंड. दिस माइट नॉट इवन एग्जिस्ट इन रियलिटी. नाउ लेट मी गिव यू अ आंसर व्हिच यू कैन राइट नाउ वर्क अपॉन. फॉर यू टू ओवरकम एनी फियर, माय फ्रेंड, टेक सम सॉर्ट ऑफ एक्शन. Take some sort of action. If you take some sort of action, your fear gets reduced. Let's say you have a fear of applying for a particular job. If I apply for this job, whether I will succeed or not, whether my resume will get shortlisted or not, and you're thinking about it, I am saying take some sort of action. Just apply. Just call the person. Reach out to that prospective employer one way or the other. When you do that, some form of fear gets reduced because you get confidence. You get some sort of certainty. Ask yourself, maybe there was a time when you had a fear. I'll give you an example. There was a time when I had a fear of speaking to women. When I moved to Bangalore at the age of 20 when I moved to Bangalore to do my MBA, I never used to speak to women. I had a big fear of speaking to women because I used to think, I don't know what I'm going to say, how am I going to approach women. I used to have a big fear. But in my MBA days, because obviously we had men, we had women, we had girls, we had boys, One day, I just decided that, you know what, I'm not going to think. I'm just going to approach somebody. I approached somebody. I had a conversation. And then I realized, यार इतना भी मुश्किल तो नहीं था किसी लड़की से बात करने का. वो भी तो ह्यूमन बीइंग ही है. बट मैंने खुद के दिमाग में लगा के रखा था, अरे यार ऑपोजिट सेक्स ऑपोजिट सेक्स ऑपोजिट सेक्स. बिकॉज मैंने खुद के दिमाग में लगा के रखा था. और वो फियर कभी ट्रू तो था ही नहीं, एग्जिस्ट तो करता ही नहीं था. दैट फियर आई क्रिएटेड. हैव यू नॉट सीन इन योर लाइफ सम ऑफ द फियर्स विच यू हैड इन लाइफ, बट व्हेन यू स्टार्टेड टेकिंग एक्शन टुवर्ड्स इट, यू रियलाइज दिस वॉज नॉट इवन अ फियर, इट इज समथिंग विच आई ओनली क्रिएटेड इन माई लाइफ. So that's the reason I was talking about all fears are self-created. But to answer your question right now, for you to overcome any kind of fear in anything, career, business, anything, take some sort of action. Because when you take some sort of action, it reduces your fear. It creates confidence. It creates certain form of certainty. So I hope that answers your question, Prabodhan. If that answers your question, mention yes in the chat box. Mention yes in the chat box. Abhishek, you have a question. I cannot see your question. Where is your question? Just hold on, Abhishek. Please answer this. Okay, I'm already into DM, but I feel content writing, copying is something that really needs patience and time, research. Even though DM too needs research, but love to do that, but I'm finding it difficult to learn copywriting. Let me know what's the best way to learn copywriting, copywriter. Also want to know how to overcome laziness, and maybe it's related to quality sleep. Any solution for this too, as ultimately it's too related to job business life. So there are two questions that Abhishek you are asking. One is how to become a good copywriter. There is more time required, patience required, research. See, Abhishek, I'll tell you something about life. In anything, there's an effort required, there's a time required. How to become best in copywriting? Just with practice. Today, take my example. When I had nobody, years back, when I got into coaching, when I started my own business, I had nobody to write copy for me. I was the one who was writing copy. So many of my copies created results. Many of my copies failed. Many of my sales landing pages failed. People did not bought my product initially because it sucked. But I became good at it because I kept writing. I was never a writer. Today I've written so many books. How? Because I kept writing. So one is through practice. Second is, when I used to write, or anybody who wants to learn copywriting, you got to write from the heart. What do I mean by that? You got to think about your audience. Who are you targeting? Who is the audience which is going to read this copy? You got to think about them. When you think about them, then you are more outward focused. When you're more outward focused, you're not trying to sell. You're trying to give value. When you give value, people will buy automatically. The first mistake that I also did is, when I used to do copywriting, I always used to think, what is the best language I should write so that people should read it and people should just click on this link and they should buy. I was thinking about selling myself. I was thinking about me. When I thought about what exactly is the problem, what exactly is the solution that they are requiring, and how exactly I should think about them, then the words came into my mind. Then I started writing on my own, because I was outward focused. And slowly and steadily, I learned the art of copywriting. But today I'm not doing it. I have people who do that, because I don't need to invest my time in copywriting, because I can have people to do that. So answering your question, yes, it will take effort. Yes, it will take time. Yes, it will take some patience. But the best way to learn copywriting is to be able to write more. Even if you want to become a writer, author, write more, and be outward focused. And the third element is, create stories in your copywriting. Give testimonials in your copywriting. If you're writing for somebody, you're trying to sell anything, give testimonials. There's a lot of system that you got to understand about copywriting. But mota, you got to make sure that you're thinking about other people and you're writing more. When you keep writing, you become better at it. So that's the way that you can go about learning copywriting. Second is, how to overcome laziness. I did a webinar yesterday. Come to my webinar tomorrow. Abhishek, come to my webinar tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. I speak about how to overcome laziness and procrastination. So I would suggest you to come to webinar so that you can listen to how to overcome laziness and procrastination in detail when I speak about the mindset part of it. I will give you a link at the end of this live call. Please register yourself and come for this free webinar. So I hope I have answered your question, Abhishek. Very good session. Fantastic. Huge yes. Any other question? How to attach own brand with personal brand? Maninder Singh, you are your personal brand. So there is nothing difference between your own brand and personal brand. You are your personal brand. So there are ways through which you can create your own personal brand. One way is, and that's also on a macro level, is everyone out there today have to have a digital identity. Today, if you don't exist on internet, if you don't exist on digital media, you don't even exist. So one of the ways, this is just one way. In this also, you have to go through in detail. It's a huge topic, Manindar, in itself. It's not that I don't want to tell you, but it's a huge topic. Personal brand is when people think of Manindar. Today, why have you come? Do you even know the name of my company? You don't even know the name of my company. In fact, for most coaches out there, most of the mentees or most of the audience of their coaches, they don't even know the name of their company. They know the person name, yes or no. Today, you know Ravneet Singh Chawla. You don't know the name of the company. All the other coaches, all the brands out there, you know their name. You don't know the company name as well. Why? Because they have created their brand around personal brand. So personal brand is when you create your own Manindar Singh out there in various ways. That's a personal brand. People will recognize you out of your name and not anything else. You might have a great product, you might have a great service, you might have a great resume, but it is your personal brand which attracts companies, which attracts audiences. So I hope that answers your question, Manindar. If yes, mention yes in the chat box. Mention yes in the chat box. Dheeraj Tiwari, Books on Mental Toughness. Dheeraj, Books on Mental Toughness. I am writing my first book on mental toughness. My first printed book on mental toughness is getting launched in a month or so. It has been delayed because of various factors. But my first book on mental toughness is Mental Toughness is a Game That You Must Master. It's getting released in a month or two. I think you should read that book. There are books on mental toughness which you can read. So one of the books that I really liked was Relentless. Relentless is a book by Tim Grover. He is from America, but he's an Indian. I love this book. In fact, my second book, which is going to come, the title of the book is called Be Relentless in Being Relentless. So I'm coming up with three books this year. All three books are on mental toughness. First, Mental Toughness is a Game That You Must Master. Second, Be Relentless in Being Relentless. Third, Stop Having a Plan B in Life. All these three books on mental toughness that I'm coming up only in this year. Three printed books. So to answer your question, one of the books that I really liked is Relentless by Tim Grover. Ashwini is asking, but you know, a word about the example you have given. Can we apply for some job and got disappointed, then what? Ashwini, if your question is if you apply for a job or if you do something and you get rejected, you get disappointed, what do you do? Please understand, Ashwini. See, first of all of these answers, all of these questions requires a big explanation, but I'm going to try to justify my answer in a short way. Ashwini, in life, you will come across various situations. You will come across various things that you're applying for, you're trying to succeed in, and you might not succeed. But that is where your relentlessness comes into the picture. You got to keep trying. First of all, the reason you get disappointed is because you have expectation. You have a certain story running in your mind. I need to get this job. I need to get this client. And your entire happiness is dependent upon these one or two things. When your entire happiness is dependent upon these expectations, obviously, you're going to be disappointed. I'm not saying not have expectations in life. But when you learn the power of mental toughness, you will have expectations, but you will not let this expectation become the reason for your disappointment. Why not? Because in this world, you can apply for multiple jobs. In this world, you can keep trying for the kind of thing that you want to succeed in. If you have filled in 10 businesses, you can start another. But that's where your pagalpan comes into the picture. That's where relentlessness, mental toughness, because it is easy to get disappointed. It is easy to quit. Because we have a certain story running in our mind, I should get this job. My husband should behave like this. If my husband is not doing the things as per my expectation, I will get disappointed. That's the reason you need to be more in control of your emotional state. I'm not saying don't have expectation, because as a human being, you will have. If you have not reached a state of enlightenment, obviously you will have. Obviously, in fact, even spiritual enlightenment people, they also have expectation. But they don't make their expectations become the reason for the disappointment, because they have more charge of their own happiness. They have more charge of their own emotional control. So Ashwini, there are two things that I'm going to tell you. First is, in this world, no matter how many times you are failing, there is always another thing that you can go for. Ask yourself, have you not failed in your life when you were trying to maybe learn how to ride a bicycle? You failed. But did you give up? No. You know why? Because as a child, you had no past references in your mind. You know what I feel. As a child, you just keep trying. You don't want to give up. You are relentless. But when you become an adult, we give up. Situations become tough, let's become disappointed. Situation becomes tough, let's go into a victim zone. I am saying become a child. Keep trying, and get a hold of your emotional state. And I'm telling you, do not worry about that you have been failing. The only thing that you should worry about is if you have stopped trying. But if you keep trying and you keep changing your ways, because you can't keep trying in the same way. If your ways are not working, change your ways. But if you keep trying and keep changing your ways, you will succeed. So I hope that answers your question. Ashwini, if yes, mention yes. Prabodhan, yes, welcome, sir. Thank you, Prabodhan. We tried to overcome the fear, but again, you got rejected. What next? I've answered your question, Ashwini. Awesome session. Very nice session. Thanks, Ravneet. Very good session, Ravneet. I will be there tomorrow for sure. Fantastic, Ashwini. So I'm saying one more time, I'm doing a free webinar tomorrow on mental toughness to succeed in finances, health and relationship. If you want to be a part of that webinar, I'm going to post a link after this live session. Please go in and register yourself. Come on time, keep your notepads and pens ready. I hope you have made notes today as well. I don't know what is the time right now, but I hope I have added a lot of value into your life. If I have added a lot of value into your life today, mention huge yes in the chat box. Thank you, Ashwini. Thank you. You are really resourceful. Mention huge yes in the chat box. And one more thing. If you think that this video needs to be seen, if this live session needs to be seen by somebody who is your friend, somebody is your colleague, somebody is your relative, somebody in your family, please go ahead and share this video. And it is not only my job to be able to contribute to people's lives, it is your job as well to be able to contribute to people's lives. If you can share this video, if you can go ahead and share this video with your friends, with the people around you, they will also learn how to create their own personal economy. Please do a favor for yourself. Spread it around. Not to get likes, comments, share, because if you get to know me personally, you will understand that no matter what we achieve in life is absolutely nothing. But if you can do things for others, guys, it allows you to be happy more. So please go ahead and share this video on your timelines with your friends, with your family members, so that more people get to see these videos. Huge, yes, fantastic, fantastic. So I hope this session has been of great value to you. And on this note, please make sure that you implement on all the points. Take one by one by one. Take one by one. And I'm sure in the next few months, in the next 1 year, you will be in a position where you're not dependent upon economy of your country, of your state, of your city. You're not dependent upon economy of the world. The four methods that I spoke about allows you to be in charge of your own personal economy. If for the last time you are with me on this, mention hell yeah Ravneet. Mention hell yeah Ravneet in the comment box. I'm going to take your leave. Mention hell yeah Ravneet in the comment box. I'm going to take your leave. Okay, I have one more question. Dinesh is asking something. How can I discover myself? Dinesh, let me answer this question. You're talking about how do I discover my purpose? How do I discover my vision? How do I discover myself? If you're talking about, there's a difference between discovering your purpose, discovering your vision, and discovering yourself. The best way to be able to discover your purpose, discover what you want to do in your life, is to discover your vision, is to keep exploring. I have this question most of the times from many people. How do I discover what do I need to do in my life? I'm confused, no clarity, whether I should be in a job, whether I should start a business, if business, what to do. Lack of clarity. Short answer is, keep exploring. When I did not know what to do in my life, I used to work in corporate world. The first clarity that I got was, I asked myself a question, do I foresee myself working in the corporate world in my late 30s, in my 40s, in my 50s? The answer that I got was a big no. So there was 50% clarity ki mujhe kya nahi karna hai. But baki 50% nahi pata tha ki kya karna hai. So this is what I did. I started exploring. I went on to an exploration mode. I started reading books. I started watching videos. I started attending courses. I started going to seminars. I spent 15 lakh rupees on my self-education at that point of time for me to do what I'm doing today. Essentially, I started exploring everything. There was a time I wanted to become a motivational speaker. But then I realized motivation does not help people create lasting results. So then I came across a word called transformation. I came across a word called coaching. And then I was very interested in coaching. Why? Because I always wanted to do something for the country. If you know me in any capacity, you would know that I'm mad about India. I'm mad about country. I'm mad about India as a country. And I wanted to become a sportsman at one point of time in my life. I wanted to become a sprinter, but I could not even take the first step to become a sportsman because of what I and my family went through in my teenage years, So there's no excuse for that, but I could not pursue that dream of mine. So when at the age of around 24, 25, when I was exploring a lot of stuff, I came across this word coaching transformation. And then I asked to myself, and I look back at my life, and I look back, have I gone through various kinds of things in my life? Have I gone through various kinds of challenges in my life? And the answer was yes. And then I asked myself, what is the best thing about me going through all these challenges and being able to overcome? The best thing was I never ever quitted in my life. There were times when me, my mom and my brother, all three of us, we did not even have the means to be able to put food onto a plate.
So I'm not going to go much into my story, but there was no support from my father. My father used to gamble on cricket matches. And from I became the man of the house at the age of 10. From the age of 10 to the age of 20, every single day was a torture for us. From my father, physical torture, mental torture, from the people who we owed money to them because of my father. Because my father took money from so many people. We lost so much of money. He never moved away from his addiction of gambling. He used to gamble on cricket matches. There was so much of savings that my mom had created. But all the savings got exhausted. My mom had to sell all of her jewelry. We came to a bankruptcy stage. My father took money in lakhs and lakhs of people, close to a crore rupees. And my father left the city. All three of us were stranded to take care of ourselves every single day. Every single day, debtors used to come to our house and used to torture us in various ways. From the age of 10, I became the man of the house. Every single day, I used to go to the school in the morning. I used to come back, used to keep my books with me to study. Because at that point of time, me studying was the only escape that I or my family had to be able to overcome the situation. So from the age of 10, every single day was a struggle for us. And when I, around the age of 24, 25, I realized one thing that I never ever quitted in my life. I had my energy levels were here, completely downhill. I was completely financially broke, but I never ever quitted in my life. So I asked myself, what can I teach people? The first thing that came into my mind is I can teach people how not to quit in their life. How not to quit in their life, which means if they don't quit, they will succeed. And that's where mental toughness came into the picture. Because mental toughness, a lot of people think that, you know what, only if you're a sportsman, then only you need mental toughness. If you are a person who is on the border of the nation as an army man, then you need mental toughness because you have to protect your country. You have to perform under pressure situations. But tell me one thing, is every single person out there, any single person out there, you are a civilian, you are a business, you are into job, are we not going through challenges in our lives on a day-to-day basis? Challenges in finances, challenges in health, challenges in relationship, challenges in various areas. Yes, if that's the case, how so many people, especially into their midlife, 30s, 40s, 50s, because into this midlife, people go through financial challenges. Why? People get stuck in corporate jobs. People get stuck in their businesses. So they go through EMI responsibilities, all of this stuff. So they quit on their path. They accept that this is what the situation is. In their health, they compromise on their health. That's the reason people become obese. People become fat. People have diabetes issues. People have BP issues. People give up on their health. People give up on their relationship. When you don't know how to manage relationship in your family, with your partner, at workplace, you give up on them. Essentially, people are quitting. And I'm saying with all respect, people are quitting in their life like this today. And the best thing that I thought of teaching people is mental toughness, because I think mental toughness is something which everybody needs to have in their life. Not because I'm teaching it, it's because this is the requirement of this world. Everybody needs to be mental tough. So I came across my purpose, I came across my vision by started exploring things. The more you explore, the more you will come to a stage where you will have certain form of interest. When you have certain form of interest, pursue that interest. When you pursue that interest, over a period of time, you will feel that, you know what, this is something that I can do. There is no magic pill out there ki yaar ek template hai aur mujhe pata lag jayega ki mujhe kya karna life mein. Kaiyon ko pata lag jata hai, maybe at the age of 5 like Sachin Tendulkar ki mujhe cricketer banna hai. Kaiyon ko nahi pata lagta, and it is okay. For you to be able to find out your purpose and vision, you got to explore everything with an open mind. The more you explore, the more you will come to a stage where something will interest you. When something will interest you, pursue that. And when that thing becomes very attractive to you, pursue that as the rest of your life. If not, change. Explore something else. That's how you come across your purpose. And how to discover yourself? It's a journey. Okay? And you got to go more within for you to discover who you are. So that's your own identity. I would not be able to explain much on that. But explore your purpose, explore your vision, and keep an open mind about life. You will get to know about yourself as well. So I hope I've answered partial question, but that's the best that I can do right now because timing is really going haywire. So I hope I've answered your question, Abhishek. Fantastic. How can you maintain consistency in workout? Kunal, again, I'm going to say, Kunal, please come to the webinar tomorrow. I'm going to speak about mindset part. So you'll get to know how to be consistent as well. I'm going to share the link. Please join. If you really want to know how to become consistent, you will get to know the solution in tomorrow's free webinar. Fantastic. So on this note, I'm going to take your leave. I'm going to even how to maintain disciplined diet. All of this I'm going to cover in the health module, Kunal, tomorrow. So please join the webinar if you want to. I'm going to share the link after this live call. Please come to the webinar. So on this note, I hope I have added a lot of value into your life today. And I hope you're going to implement, you're going to execute. Because execution is the key. Implementation is the key. Learning information is not the key. Implementation. And for that to happen, change this part. That's where everything starts, everything ends. So on this note, thank you all of you, and I'm going to take your leave.
And thank you for coming for this live session. I love all of you. Mwah. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Please spread this video to everyone out there. Thank you so much.